President William Ruto has been confronting tension from Azimio Umoja Party pioneer Raila Odinga to bring down the cost for many everyday items for Kenyans by diminishing how much charges that the public authority is forcing on different wares that are basically utilized consistently by residents. In response to these demands, the government has provided inexpensive maize flour, which costs approximately 160 Kenyan shillings. Ladama Alakina, a senator from Narok, has acknowledged that President Ruto is not to blame for the government's high taxes. Many people were surprised by the senator's admission because he has always blamed the president for almost everything bad that happens in the country. Ladama revealed that the lawmakers elected by the people who are passing bills that do not benefit the common man and woman are to blame for the high tax rates. Members of parliament are the ones who raise the fuel tax to 16% without taking into account how it will affect everyday purchases of essential goods. He continued by stating that these parliamentarians always comply with Ruto's demands. People are talking about Raila Odinga supporters on a variety of social media platforms. After finally telling Raila that he was wrong for stopping demonstrations, this happened. As per the source, the furious allies were saying that Odinga shouldn't stop demos out of the blue, whereby Type said that the news that Raila's supporters told him he did the wrong thing by stopping demonstrations has gone viral on a number of social media platforms, eliciting mixed reactions at the moment. While some supporters of Azimio are out to say that they should concentrate on living their lives and stop talking about demonstrations, others are out to say that Raila did a good job, simultaneously stopping demonstrations. Anyway, how do you feel about supporters of Azimio claiming that Raila was not supposed to stop demonstrations? Co2K manager Francis Atwoli has gotten down on Azimio pioneers for wading into controversy with the understanding that Kenyan laborers allegedly made with the Kenya Kwanzaa government. Atwoli has said that the people who are griping over the 3% lodging demand are similar individuals who skipped workday festivities, in which they purportedly talked about and settled on everything with the president. He has noticed that a 3% lodging demand will give Kenyan laborers reasonable homes, adding that isn't a duty as a segment of lawmakers are guaranteeing. Atwoli noticed that the Kenya Kwanzaa government has previously clarified that it has proactively put KSH 5 billion into the lodging asset, and that the individuals who add to the lodging store and later wish to pull out their commitments will approach their investment funds with revenue. It is important to note that the 3% housing levy does not constitute a tax, and that this is an excellent effort to construct low-cost housing for Kenyan workers. In addition, every Kenyan has the right to accessible and adequate housing, as well as reasonable sanitation standards, according to Co2K's statement in part. Criticizing leaders. According to Atwoli, those attempting to criticize the government's move are merely engaging in political games. He claimed that on Labor Day, he invited all labor unions to share their opinions, but they did not show up. Therefore, the politicization of a constitutional right and an agreement between the government and workers is extremely regrettable. Co2 added, Co2K would like to encourage the trade unionists who skipped the celebrations for Labor Day and the meeting with the president to embrace social dialogue and stop politicizing serious matters. Thanks for watching.